In Genesis and Exodus, you see that the Lord is pulling together for himself his own people. They're books full of energy and big narrative stories of his goodness to them. The next book in the Old Testament, though, is Leviticus. And as you read Leviticus, what you see is God's attention is turning to how his family, his nation, is to be ordered. I've recently been reading this book, and I've come to chapter 23, where the Lord speaks to Moses about festivals. He says to Moses three things. That in celebrating festivals, his people are to have rest in their life. Secondly, he says they are to be a people who celebrate. And thirdly, in their rest and in their celebration, they are to be people of offering. At the beginning of lockdown, we were due to hold our annual special offering for Hope Church. And we felt as elders just to pause on that. But now as we come to this summer season, where we are experiencing both rest and celebration, spending time with family and friends, we feel it's right to come and ask you as Hope Church to join in not just a celebratory offering or a special offering, but a new era offering. We are in the midst of one of the largest revolutions of communication that we would have experienced. But I also want to say this to you. I believe this is one of the most significant resetting that the Lord has in how his church is structured and communicates the gospel. And we believe that in this season, in this summer, and as we go into the autumn, we should be preparing for this new era that was shared with us by Steve Oliver last year. In Leviticus 23, the Lord says one of the last ones is to celebrate by making temporary shelters. He says to his people, leave your permanent homes and move into a shelter of your own hands for 7 days. Why would he do that? He does that so that they would remember that the Lord is both their deliverer and he is their provision. But also he's reminding them that the ordinances he's given are before they come into the promised land. They're to sacrifice of themselves before they get to this new era. And lastly, there's a reminder in that this is not our home. That our response to coming out of the lockdown is not to indulge ourselves, but to say, Lord, we're ready for mission. Will you join with us as we go on mission again as Hope Church? There are big words over us in this season. Words that we will grow and not diminish, that our influence and profile will increase and not dissipate. But at the beginning of the year, we received this word, and it was through Matt Lofthouse. I am standing before a large mansion, holding a large bunch of keys. The mansion's door in front of me is locked until Jesus comes and opens the main door. Immediately, people come, and they join me. Each taking a key and unlocking a different size and functioned room in the mansion. We believe the new era for Hope Church will lead to a massive multiplication of emphasis and ownership of what God has called us to do. And over the next few weeks, each Sunday, we will be talking about a different aspect of what we believe God is calling us to do. We believe in this season he's calling us to both multiply gifts and leadership for the equipping of the church. We want every congregation to have a congregational leader working for the church. We're believing in this season that we should bring on staff ministerial apprentices that we can train up to go lead churches. Secondly, we believe that as we continue to be online, that we are an online community experienced in physical locations, and we want to invest to make the most of that opportunity. Thirdly, we know that we will be able to go back and meet physically very soon, but in doing that, we want to relaunch every congregation and not just Bromley North, and that needs resourcing. Fourthly, we want to release the church for micro-mission. Previously, we've been building around programs and asking you to come volunteer. But we want to talk to you about an amazing, exciting opportunity where we can release you on mission and support you both financially and through mentorship. But on a bigger level, fifthly, we believe this is a season where God is calling us to establish a community presence. We believe in the foundation project of the food hub. There's more to come, and we will be doing grants to support that. Will you prayerfully pray and stand with us as we see all that God has for us in this new era? Let's come like the people of God. Let us come in this season, yes, rest, yes, celebrate, but let's come with our offerings as we push into this new era.